Hi there, and welcome to another video in the Scriptcase Macros course. Today we're looking at the SC Master Value Macro. So my name is Nate Carpenter, and I'm the Scriptcase instructor leading this course where we're going through all the macros and showing you how to use them. So this macro, SC Master Value, changes the value of an object on a master application from a child application. So this is very useful when you have some logic going on in the child application that needs to take effect in the master application. Here's a documentation for it. So you pass through the name of the object and then the value here. So the object name of the master application, and it does not, if it's a field, it does not need to be in the curly braces like we typically would do. And then the value that we're going to assign to that object. So here's an example of doing that. So there's a select statement done, then some number formatting done. So if you're passing through certain numbers, you need to make sure you format them correctly. And then a master value call to that macro. So as it says down here, if it's numeric, some of the numeric values you need to pass through. For today's application, we're not going to do that. But let's go ahead and go over to Scriptcase now. So I've got two applications set up here, and we'll look at those in a second. But for now, let's look at the database here. So I'm going to pull up a database diagram here. Let me choose my database. And we're going to be looking at two tables, the customer table and the address table. So as you can see, let me find the customer table here. I've got a lot of tables. There it is. So there's a customer table. And if you look at that, I have an address ID on that table right there. That is the address ID, and that links it to the address table right up here. So there's the address table. Let me drag it below there. So that address ID on the customer table links to the address ID on the address table. So the address is going to be our child form, and our customer is going to be our master form. So let's go ahead and look at our customer form here. So just a basic form. Let me go ahead and run it here. Actually, let me show you the detail. I've got that set up. So I've got master detail address here, and it's linked to that form address master value right there. That grid right there, that form, I mean. So let me go ahead and run this so you can see how I have this child form set up inside of the master form. So here's the master form, and then right below in this address block, so here's the address ID, and then below in the address block is the record linked based on that address ID right there. So we need to go ahead when we click add new and we add a new address, we need to assign that address ID value that's generated from the address table. So let's look at the address form now. So this is just a basic form. I've got a few fields here to assign an address. And then I also have an address ID right here. And as you can see, that's an auto increment value from the database. So we don't know that until the record is created. So let's go ahead and copy this example right here. And we're going to put it on the on after insert event on our child form. So we need to go to events and then after insert. So that's after the record has been inserted and that address ID has been auto incremented. So we know what it is now. So we insert there. And then we execute this code. So we need to assign the object. We need to figure out what that is. So that's going to be a field over here. That's the address ID field right there. So put that in there, and it does not need to be in the curly braces. So address underscore ID, and then assign the value. So that's going to come from the address ID of this table right here that was just created. So that's not shown on screen, but that is there. Let me make sure it's spelled correctly. So that'll just been generated there. So let's generate this source so that it's ready to go. And now this should work. That's pretty much all we need to do. So let's go ahead and run this. And we're going to add a new record. So we first need to create the master record before we can create a child record. So let's go ahead and create a master record here. So I'm going to put in a name and email. So that is our customer information. We're going to leave address ID blank for now. And then go ahead and click add on this. And now we have the option to add a new address associated with this customer. So we click add new and type in our address. So I'm just going to type in a dummy address here. And put some dummy values in here. It doesn't really matter at this point. Select a city. We've got a list of cities. Put a postal code in. Phone number in. And then when we click add, the address ID should be updated on the master application. So wait for that to load. There it is. And then as you can see, the address ID has been updated. So now 607 is the ID of the address for that customer. So that's how you use the SC Master Value macro to update a value on the master application.